Okay, so yeah, we're talking auditing. Let's say you're stuck on a certain concept where they say, I'm struggling to understand audit procedures, and you want to understand what do they mean when they talk about audit procedures. Audit procedures, basically, according to my own understanding, you have the right to keep your own understanding. According to my understanding, audit procedures, they're basically saying, it's more like formulate instructions. Okay, let's say you're a mechanic, right? Then you're a very, very qualified mechanic. You know your way around fixing cars. Then I come and let's say I'm a doctor, I'm a medical doctor. I know nothing about fixing a car and what's done to fix a car. When people are talking about audit procedures, they're basically saying you, as the mechanic, give me instructions. So you're instructing someone like who's coming from a medical profession, you're in the mechanical side of things. So you literally have to tell me what to do, okay? Turn the knob, what is this? Open the bonnet to do 1, 2, 3. Check the battery if it's 1, 2, 3. Check is not a good word to use when you're formulating audit procedures. Inquire about 1, 2, 3, do 1, 2, 3. But audit procedures, you are giving instructions to your junior. So if they're saying formulate audit procedures, look at it this way, as if you are the senior in that state. Then there is this first year who knows nothing about auditing, and you are telling them what to do. So you are giving them instructions. So audit procedures with basically talking about you giving instructions. It is very, very helpful. It will be very, very helpful, I think, for those who be doing third level auditing, where you have to now formulate those instructions. It's like you're telling someone, procedure, what is the process? That's what they're trying to say. Tell someone. So basically, the two, if my understanding is not mistaken, because Ash is auditing, the two, there is a test of controls, then there's the substantive procedures. So they will tell you, usually they tell you what they want you to perform, but I just want to give you like a nutshell, it in the whole, like in its all completeness and whatever. When they're saying audit procedures, please, 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 they're just saying formulate instructions. Give instructions what to do. Your junior doesn't know what to do. So you, the senior, you have to now tell the junior, do 1, 2, 3, do 1, 2, 3, do 1, 2, 3. And that process is done to collect audit evidence, right? Audit evidence, what is audit evidence, is one of the most difficult things to explain. But in my own view, it's the basis of your report. You're gonna make a comment based on that evidence. It's not gonna be like just the hard evidence, because some of it is processes. So make sure you understand when you're talking about audit procedures, these are instructions, right? You are giving your junior instructions. Go do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 things, right? So there are tests of controls. Even from the name test of controls, you go in to test the control, right? It's not enough for you to believe the door is locked because you see the door shut, right? The control there would be probably, let's say there's a key there. It's not enough for you to just look at it and say, that door is closed, right? We are auditors. You have to put your mindset in. You have to become an auditor in those 10 seconds. You're an auditor, you're supposed to be paranoid. So you have to go and physically. So the test of con the procedure that, what is this? The audit procedure that you then perform, you have to now physically try to turn the handle to see, is this door locked? Is this door closed? That's basically how to formulate those instructions. So you're going to be given either via test of controls or on the substantive procedure, perform a substantive procedure. So those are the two things that you just have to understand when you're doing auditing. It's not really so difficult. It's not tough. It's something that you can do. There's a lot of theory, but when they're talking about audit procedures, they are talking about audit instructions. Okay, what instructions are you going to give to your junior to perform? So if you look at it from that perspective that, okay, perform what list the audit procedures for wara. You now teach yourself, tell yourself, okay, if I was to be in this situation and I'm to be the senior, what am I going to tell my junior to do? From then onwards, you start drafting your audit procedures. Please try not to be repetitive. A lot of students struggle. They keep on repeating the same thing. They keep on repeating, changing the same words. You change the words, you repeat this. You change the words, you repeat the same thing. Guys, lecturers are quite smart. Please don't try to outsmart them in that way. They know. Okay, don't repeat yourself. And don't write incomplete procedures. Incomplete procedures is just like saying, turn the doorknob. Then you stop there. Why are you turning the doorknob? You have to also tell us, okay, turn the doorknob to do 1, 2, 3, to confirm if the door is locked. Why are you doing the procedure? Make sure your procedure is complete. Don't stop in between. Make sure the procedure in its entirety is complete. So please have fun with auditing. Study. But as you do it, especially on a third level basis, apply. It's no longer like just a theory dump, but apply. Apply what you know, and keep on applying what you know. So that's pretty much it about auditing procedures. I hope it won't be a very, very complicated subject. And Yebo, I look forward to hearing from comments from you. Like, subscribe, share, do the right thing. And I'll see you on the next video. Thank you so much.